Oh my God. Look at that. Halley's Comet, baby. Look at that. Oh my God. What is that?
Thompson says the meteor burned for about 2 minutes.
Well, anyway, if your name's Lucy, good on you. That's
right. You can call it after yourself if you really want.
You can be part of it if you want. Exactly. Yeah. Now, Brad, mysterious radio signals have been detected near the center of the Milky Way galaxy.
But just speaking of life, random radio signals we were picking up. Is this life?
Not aliens, unfortunately not, but probably some other new random excitement thing in the center of our galaxy. Maybe one day it will be aliens, but I don't think it's today.
The heart of the Milky Way galaxy, also known as the galactic center, is emitting some unusual radio waves, extraordinary signals that are unlike anything known to mankind. They've been discovered by a team of scientists at the University of Sydney. The scientists say these signals are beyond their understanding.
They're not coming from a star or a planet, but from a new kind of celestial object. The story is truly puzzling.
And when staring at the Milky Way, they saw one area that had a signal, but the signal, it didn't stay on or didn't stay off. It kept popping on and off, but at weird times. So there was no rhyme or reason, so to speak. And then things in space usually have a repeated pattern because they're going around something or they're spinning. They kind of have a natural speed or rate. The fact that this is changing seemingly constantly is quite an interesting surprise. Now, we don't think it's aliens, but we do think maybe it's a new class of an object. Maybe it's some sort of new type of star that's erupting or variable or exploding. So a really cool discovery, once again, here from Australia.
What is that?
A pattern of lights over Paterson, New Jersey on Monday night caused a bit of a stir with residents on the ground, all trying to make sense of the unidentified flying objects.
There's a lot of them, bro.
Lewis Stevens, who was on the ground filming the spectacle, says he lost count of what he called flying white circles that he says morphed into different shapes.
You see it on YouTube and you be like, it's always somewhere out in Nevada desert somewhere. The shock was more like, is this really real? Like, are we really looking at what we think we're looking at? Headed toward those.
The mysterious lights dazzled the skies over downtown Paterson for more than 5 minutes, Stephen said, ending their run over nearby Garrett Mountain. PIX 11 News sent the video to the Federal Aviation Administration, where an official reviewed it, checking in with local air traffic. We were told nothing unusual was reported.
There's a lot of them, bro.
Now, whether they were drones or some supernatural phenomenon remains unclear. Officials are urging members of the public who do see this type of activity to report it to the National UFO Reporting Center, or if they feel their life or property are in danger, to call police.
Well, good morning. Yeah, you can see this thing from all over Metro Detroit, all over the state, even in another country. Canada, right next door. The good news is we know it's not an alien invasion.
A giant slow-moving fireball was seen all over Southeast Michigan. You had to be up pretty late to see it.
It's a bird, it's a plane, it's a fireball. Around 12:45 this morning, those who were awake, like Chris Johnson in Port Huron, saw this in the sky. They were wondering what the heck it is. But it wasn't just Chris in Port Huron. This was seen all over Metro Detroit. Tim Shank recorded this video in Romulus. It turns out that it's likely a piece or a part of a meteor shower that really is going to be seen even better tonight.
Now at 5, several Hoosiers in Hamilton County saw something in the sky early this morning.
This is pretty interesting. People have speculated that it could be anything from a meteor to a UFO. Astronomy professor at Butler says it's most likely just a piece of space debris re-entering Earth's orbit.
It is a spectacular sight when you see these things. I haven't seen things re-enter like this.
Professor Brian Murphy with Butler University says it was likely not a meteor, as you just heard, because it was moving too slowly. If it was coming in front from outside our orbit, it would be moving around 4 times faster, he says, than what we saw there.
It's totally a UFO.
Well, a NASA rocket blasted off just before dawn this morning, beginning a 12-year quest to explore a group of asteroids orbiting Jupiter. The spacecraft, named Lucy, took off from Cape Canaveral, Florida.
Scientists believe the mission will shed light on some of the solar system's least understood objects. In December, NASA's going to launch the James Webb Space Telescope. You know, this is the successor to Hubble that's going to supposedly see light from the very first stars and galaxies that formed after the Big Bang. NASA's building another spacecraft called the Europa Clipper. And so I think it's a lot of fun. It's a great time to be watching all this. Being able to learn these things about the solar system that we never knew before is truly fascinating.